Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello and good morning students. We are doing the third topic of the second chapter, that is relation between linear and angular velocity. So we've seen what linear velocity is, what angular velocity is. Let's see how they relate to each other. So relation between linear and angular velocity. Linear velocity is denoted by v and angular velocity is denoted by omega. So we'll derive this relation between them. For that we need to just assume a small motion along a curve. So let's see how they're related. Just imagine a rod OA which is performing a circular motion. So we'll imagine a small angular displacement. So suppose the rod OA moves from this position to the second position, as you can see in the diagram. Now it takes some amount of time to go from the first to the second position and it will cover some angle. The angle that it will cover is d theta, or you can write theta as well. So this is a small, since the angle covered is very small, we can write d theta as well. There's no problem in that. Or if you want, you can write theta. There's no problem in that as well. So let's see the small sector. Let's just remove the small sector out of the circle and look at it. So this is how it looks like if you remove it from the circle. If you just concentrate on the sector, it will look like something like this. The angle is theta and the red thing that you can see is the displacement, linear displacement. Now the question arises, since the motion is circular, how can I say that the red part is the linear displacement? I've imagined that the displacement is very small, the angular displacement is very small. So if you consider a very small part of a circle, it looks almost like a line. So you can consider it as a line, and since it is a line, the displacement can be called as linear displacement. It is along a curve, I understand that, but I have imagined that the angular displacement is very small. So the arc almost looks like a line. So you can write the displacement as linear displacement x. And let the radius of the circle be r. So we have three things here. We have x, that is the arc of a circle, which is almost a line since it is very small. Now we have r, the radius of the circle, and we have theta. Now these three variables are related to each other. So from geometry we can write x is equal to r times theta. X is equal to r times theta. This is we get from geometry. This is a very basic thing that you study in your lower standards, 8th standard, 9th standard, you have already seen this. Now what we have to do is we have to differentiate this equation with respect to time. And time we denote as t. Since r is constant, you can keep r outside and differentiate theta. So this is what we get. Now from linear motion, you can say that dx by dt is nothing but v and d theta by dt is nothing but omega. So I've derived the relation, that is v equal to r times omega. So the linear velocity is nothing but the radius times the angular velocity. It's a very important relation that is asked in exams. So also you need to know this equation because you'll be using it in all the numericals that will be solving ahead. So V is equal to R times omega is the relation between linear and angular velocity. And only thing that can bother you in this topic is I've taken x as linear displacement, even though it's along a curve, just because the motion of the rod, the angle that the rod has covered is very small, so the displacement is very less, so the arc almost looks like a line. So it is, this is applicable only when the motion happens for a very small angle. So I hope you've understood this relation. Thank you so much.